Hey, this is Wes with Missouri Wind and Solar. Before you even start to comment again that Jeff's not here, he's in Tasmania doing research on vampire bats, still enjoying his retirement. But we're up on the roof again today, this time ahead of a pretty substantial storm coming in, so we're gonna move a little bit quickly because we both wanna get off of this roof pretty quick. But we wanted to do a video on the Chinese wind turbines that you're seeing on Amazon and eBay right now, and they're running like $100 for anywhere from, it looks like, about 300 watts to 500 or 600 watts. So we bought one on Amazon about 3 months ago. I think we paid like $120 for it or something like that. It's a 400 watt wind turbine. Put it up here. It's been up here for about 3 months now, generating. One of the nice things we were able to do is we were able to use one of our existing brackets. This is our vault mount, and we were able to use it with that wind turbine, so we didn't have to go to all the issues with welding that a lot of those instructions with that show you, having to weld the wind turbine onto the pole. So it's been up here running. It's this one right here behind me. It's an interesting unit. It seems to be pretty well built. It's tracking, you know, it's spinning. We've got a lot of activity out of it. The thing that just has surprised us is that we haven't got the wattage out of it anywhere near what it's rated. So the top wattage that we've seen really come out of it is about 100 watts on a 400 watt wind turbine. What we're gonna do is go down into the area where our power comes in. We've got this on a meter. We've got our wind ratings. We can see all that happening and actually show you what that wind turbine is putting out. Okay, we're back. We had to wait a few days to get some sustained winds around 20 miles per hour, and today's a pretty good day for that. You're looking back here. This is the Missouri Wind and Solar Power Plant in Seymour. If you decide to ever come and shop at the store, we'll take you back here and show you a lot of good methodology and how we've got our system built. But I wanted to take a minute and focus in on the wind speed here on the anemometer. We always have an awful time saying that. So we'll take a moment and get focused in here, and I'll show you what's going on. All right, so this cable is coming in from the wind turbine up on the roof. We've got our switch here. This is actually their charge controller, and it's probably too far away to see, but this is rated at a 400 watt wind turbine. And it's coming into our own Missouri Wind digital meter here. And you can see our power wattage is right here. Right now it's running 53, 57, 70 watts. The anemometer is here, and you can see our wind speeds are moving right in the 20 mile per hour range. If you watch this power meter, it very seldom, I've only seen it hit 100 watts one time. And what's interesting about this is that when you get up into that range, you'll see a little red light come on here where we're pretty sure that it is auto braking that wind turbine. So the controller that they are sending, it may not even allow it to produce the 400 watt that it's rated for, because it seems to go ahead and do the braking when it starts to spin up that high. But we've never seen this thing consistently produce 100 watts in any kind of fashion, regardless of the wind speed. So while it is an interesting wind turbine, I think getting anywhere near the ratings on these is a long shot at best. So we just wanted to bring you in here and show you that. We've been monitoring this for a couple of months now, just trying to see if you know, there's something that's going on different for us. But really, it's just not going to produce that much power. This is Wes with Missouri Wind and Solar. We appreciate you watching the video. If you like us, give us a thumbs up. If you'd like to get more of our videos and get notified when they're out, hit the bell. And we'll keep bringing you videos from here in Missouri. Thanks a lot.